Hey guys, welcome back to another Dragonball FighterZ video. Today, we're going to be doing a tier list since Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta recently came out. But I gotta preface with a couple of things real quick. You see, I'm not a professional Dragon Ball FighterZ player. I'm just a dude who loves the game. So this is really just for entertainment purposes. And also, in the comments down below, let me know where you would put some of these characters. But before we get into that, I gotta pick the winners for the giveaway. And you should be seeing the winners on your screen now. Right, so those are our winners for the giveaway. Hopefully everyone enjoyed, and thank you once again for partaking. I really do appreciate it. Here's what my B tier looks like. I still think, man, Zamasu and Goku Black, they need some love. They are not sitting in a good place. And it's weird, man, because Goku Black has a lot of really good tools, and Zamasu does as well. I mean, granted, Zamasu's Ki Blast is absolute trash. But they're salvageable, you know? These aren't bad characters. I mean, they are, but they have the potential to be good. And honestly, like, every character in B tier right here are characters that I would love to see get some buffs in the next balance patch. That way we see them more often in ranked fights. Like, I swear, I'm one of two Nappa players in all of existence. Alright, so here are my A tiers. And to be honest, they're not 100% in order. It's kind of loosely thrown together in there. But this is more or less what I think would be the A tiers. Honestly, 100%. Baby could be S tier. I mean, this is a really strong character. His level 3s are amazing. His level 1 is versatile and pretty good. And his Ki Blasts are absolutely ridiculous. Fighting a really good Super Baby 2 player, they're gonna lock you down not only with the Ki Blast, but your dead assist as well. So I think it's 100% fair to plop him right into the S tier. And when it comes down to Vegito, I feel like a lot of characters do what he does, but they do it better. And those characters, for the most part, are an S tier. This is a character that needs an assist in order to really open people up effectively, because doesn't really have much to do it on his own. Now for our S tiers. Master Roshi's an absolute powerhouse. The guy's crazy. I mean, if you get this character in the hands of somebody who knows how to use him, you're pretty much gonna lose. Like, Master Roshi is an absolute unit of a character. This is one of those guys, as well as Ginyu. This is another character you can say this about, where when you see them loading into the fight, and you see that they got like a Captain Ginyu or a Master Roshi player card, and that's also their Z Union, and so on and so forth, you know they know that character. Like, you know they put all their time into that. And you have to be concerned. You gotta watch out for your life. But I feel like the amount of time you have to put into the character in order to actually get any return is something that most people aren't willing to do. And I think it's 100% fair in order to say that he's pretty underexplored even still. So I feel like Master Roshi, in the hands of a really good player, is easily S tier and possibly even S plus. But in your average player, I think he's pretty A tier. I don't think I really need to say much about any of the other characters here. Piccolo is Piccolo. He's, you know, he's a really great character, even though a lot of people don't really play him very much. GT Goku, while he might have gotten nerfed since Season 2, he's still really good. And same thing with Bardock. You know, he got a little power crept on, and he got nerfed with his assist, but he's still a great character. Yamcha is really just reliable, and overall amazing. Wait, hold up. How did Z Broly end up here? That's not where he went. What? I have no idea how Z Broly got down there. But Z Broly deserves to be, like, number one character, if not Kid Buu. I feel like one of these two is definitely the best character. And Kid Buu recently just got some nerfs, so I would feel more comfortable putting Z Broly up there, with UI Goku maybe as a close second, and Kid Buu third. I think that's pretty reasonable. And then have the rest of the roster a little something like that. With UI's most recent changes, I mean, he's a lot easier to deal with. You see, I was one of those people that was looking for nerfs on this character, and not because he was too strong, but because it felt like he got way too much for free. Even when he messed up, and he threw something out there that he shouldn't have, you still couldn't punish it. He'd launch himself to the opposite side of the screen and there was nothing to do about it. So it always kind of felt bad whenever he would get something that he didn't deserve. All the other characters pretty much remain the same. Z Broly is Z Broly. Base Vegeta is still as good as ever. And Android 21, I think a lot of people are starting to put some respect on Homegirl, and she deserves it because she's an absolute amazing character. And once you crack her open, once you figure out how to use her, she's got quite the toolkit. Now, Blue Goku's got a lot of nice tools. He's got a lot that he can work with, and he makes a phenomenal point character. Initially, my previous tier list, I put him a little bit lower, but you guys gave me some feedback and told me that I should probably rock him a little bit higher, so I think it's fair to say that he's either S tier or S plus. Although I think it's a little fair to put him about here. Now, Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. This is a character, a new DLC, that I think they did a great job balancing. He's got a lot of really good tools, like his command grab, his amazing auto combo, his really good range, and his extremely safe buttons. But he's got a massive drawback. And that's, he kind of sucks at neutral. So I feel like in the hands of the average player, he'd probably be like S tier or maybe high A tier. But in the hands of a professional player, I can easily see him being S plus or really high S. But let me know where you guys think Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta places on the tier list. I think I'm gonna put him right here. We still have a lot of experimenting and learning to do with this character. And once we explore more, we'll get the full picture as to how good he is. But for now, I think this is a pretty respectable spot. Because when you think of it, somebody like Piccolo also doesn't really have a full screen option. I mean, the GBA's got the Oki orbs he's famous for, but they're not your traditional projectile that you would use necessarily the same way as other characters. And yet, he's regarded as being a really powerful character, so there's more to being high tier than just simply having a nice projectile. Alright, I think that pretty much wraps up today's video. If you guys have any suggestions as to who you think should be placed where on the tier list, be sure to let me know in the comments down below. And while you're at it, remember to hit the like button, it helps out a bunch. Now, if this is the first time you come across my content, feel free to subscribe, become part of this amazing thing we got going here. I'd love to see you guys back here in tomorrow's video. And if you're looking for some more Dragon Ball FighterZ to watch, I got a video here on the left-hand side of your screen. In the spirit of Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, I came out with a lot of combo tutorials, so here we got ourselves a B&B tutorial, really practical stuff that you can use in your ranked fights. Now, on the right-hand side, this is a really fun ranked fight that we had, where we stole somebody's DLC. It was an absolute blast and full of laughs. So pick whichever one you think fits you best, and as always, thank you guys for watching to the end. I really do appreciate it. I'll catch you guys tomorrow, but until then, have yourselves a wonderful day.